356th time in legendary Memorial Stadium in the heartland of America, Lincoln, Nebraska. Yet another sellout as the Cornhuskers play host to the Huskies of Northern Illinois. Hi again, everyone. Tim Brando, so happy to be with you. And look at this, Spence.
He looks good.
We've
brother.
Got the hat without
still
the hat.
Hanging around.
But a lot of knowledge this guy's got. Les Miles is in the booth with us. Let's begin by talking defense. Nebraska's 3-4 vaunted approach with Bob Diaco. Yeah. Not as successful, largely because of injuries. Three of their best defensive backs are out. What do you make of this opportunity they have today, coming off a shutout performance in Eugene in the second half?
It's a huge opportunity to show that they are consistent. For three quarters, for the most part, they weren't, and then they turned it on in the fourth stop. As you mentioned, three of their top defenders are not in the mix on the back end. Chris Jones, chief among them, the cornerback, closest thing they have to a shutdown corner. This 3-4 scheme and the spread error, Tim, is ideal because it allows you to get flexibility and skill position players in position to make great plays. But you've got to be disciplined, and that's what Bob Diaco's got to have from his players.
Well, we've successfully brought our friend to the dark side. But right now, Les, I want you to take us into your world. You're Rod Carey, you're Mike Riley. Tell me what you're telling your guys coming into today's game.
Rod Carey has got to take a team that's lined up in this locker room and bring them out to the field and take over Husker Stadium, this Memorial Stadium. And simply put, they don't respect us. They don't enjoy us. They don't understand that six of the last seven MAC championships we participated in. They don't understand when we play Big Ten teams, we play to win. Five times in the last nine times, we win. So we're going to go earn respect today. We're going to go out that tunnel. We're going to play our ass off.
How about Nebraska? What about Mike Riley?
Nebraska,
his
it's
guys
different.
Get in that tunnel.
It's different. It's all about us. This we got a path. We're going to direction. We're going to win for the conference. We're going to win for our opportunity to win a conference championship. That is where he's at. He's going to say, we go to the field today for your friends, your family, and those people that are sitting in the stands, and you're going to be intimately attached to that group, and you're going to play your tail off. Why? Because you're Huskers.
Bring the juice, Les. We love that. Here they are making their way up. And this was your specialty. I know you love this. Probably the part you miss most, right?
Yeah, it is a great tradition. It's a, they come through the crowd. I can tell you, I have been talked to by people on the perimeter that's the sweetest fans in the history of college football. But when you take a team to the field, they risk injury. They have goals. They want to be great fathers, husbands, and men. They want to get degrees. And this is a part of an experience that they can't overlook.
And then you like to hold them back. And I know you like to rock with them, all that tension,
rock
all
it,
that
baby.
Excitement. And you get to turn them loose, baby.
That was Honey Badger, so you know, baby. I'm telling you, Tyron Matthew.
Yes, sir.
Tyron Matthew was all about it.
Here come the Cornhuskers.
My son Ben Miles is back in that spot.
When we come back, the third member of our broadcast team, Holly Saunders, joins us. It's Northern Illinois and Nebraska.
Nationwide is on your side.
What'd you think?
We're almost there. On the jingle, though, Brad, I want to feel it right here.
Mm-hmm. Like here in right. the chest?
No, your heart.
Heart.
In your heart. Mm-hmm. Yes! Close. We're almost there. Almost.
Well, basically got it, right?
Basically almost, but you're doing great.
What did I just get into?
Nothing.
Remember 2007? Smartphones? OMG. 10 years later, nothing's really changed. It's time to snap out of it.
Hello, Moto.
Snap on a JBL speaker. Put a 70-inch screen on a wall. Get a 10 times optical zoom. Get excited, world.
Hello, Moto.
Moto is here. The new Moto Z with Moto Mods. Get a Moto Z Play for only $10 a month. No trade-in required.
This month at DQ, we're calling all chocolate cake lovers.
If you'll indulge me, I'd love to tell you about our indulgent best chocolate cake blizzard.
It's chocolatey.
Velvety.
Yes, it is rich.
Much like my phone voice.
The new DQ best chocolate cake blizzard and molten lava cake a la mode.
Welcome to Dairy Queen.
It's great to finally meet you. Your parents have been talking about you for years.
They're all about me saving for a house or starting a college fund for my son.
Actually, I want to know what you're thinking.
Knowing that the most important goals are yours, it's how Edward Jones makes sense of investing.
It is the MAC against the Big Ten, and we're in Lincoln, Nebraska. As I mentioned a moment ago, Holly Saunders is with us, and Les touched on it, Holly. This is a Mid-America Conference team that's had success against the Big Ten.
You're exactly right, Tim, and many of these Northern Illinois players are familiar with the Big Ten programs and familiar because they were actually overlooked during the recruiting process by these Big Ten programs. And now these snubs have turned into chips on their shoulders. But let me tell you, Rod Carey, their head coach, is very efficient when it comes to coaching teams who have chips on their shoulders deep into Big Ten territory. Like, if you remember back to 2013, Jordan Lynch and the Huskies won a thriller at Iowa on that field goal in the closing seconds. Then later that season, Northern Illinois won by 31 points at Purdue. That absolute blowout. Then in 2014, the Huskies knocked off a Trevor Siemian-led Northwestern. And in 2014, took on number one Ohio State and lost by just a touchdown. Tim, as I send it back to you here.
All right, Christian Hagan will kick it away. Nebraska won the toss, elected to receive. Speedsters Tajon Lindsey and J.D. Spielman are back deep. It comes down to Lindsey, and he dropped it into the end zone. He could stay in, and that's what he needs to do, and he does once the ball goes through there. So he got a little bit of help from Spielman. I think he may have thought, because he had touched it inbounds, that he had to bring it out. He did not. The freshman came up with a heady play to keep him in the end zone for the touchback.
First thing you got to do is help him out, tell him to stay back in. That communication was great.
First down, Northern Illinois.
That's the kind of leadership you're looking for from a young player.
That's J.D. He's football smart, as you know, because he is the son, adopted son, of Rick Spielman, the general manager of the Vikings, and our colleague Chris Spielman is the uncle of J.D. He's already had a kickoff return for a touchdown. You're looking at Tanner Lee, the numbers on him, pass interceptions, a couple of them really brought on by lack of protection a week ago. Great arm, perfect to run this Mike Riley pro-style offense, and it's a quick hitch to Spielman to start, and he gets it ahead to the 32-yard line. Mikelty Williams with the grab, a pickup of 7, and let's get Tillman's takes.
Timmy, first of all, Nebraska's already done it, gotten off to a fast start, stressing the perimeter. We thought they would do it with their run game, but they're showing you that they've got some flexibility. And then, if you're on the opposite side for NIU, you've got to play takeaway. Nebraska's only going to run about 70 plays, but if you ball control it, you can really put them in a bind.
Mikhail Wilbon in for the injured Trey Bryant in the backfield, and he'll tote it this time. Has the first down before being thrown out. Mikhail Wilbon, 5'9", 195-pounder. He's got quick, short, choppy steps. He's hungry to advance it. Should get about 18 to 20 carries today.
Yeah, it's important that he gets a fast start as well, because he really is the guy that can you know, take over for Trey Bryant.
Bryant, by the way, just had back-to-back 100-yard performances. It had been a while since that occurred, but a problem with his knee that had been injured before cropped up against Oregon. Beautiful out pattern, and it's caught by DeMorne Pearson-L. He had some big-time catches a week ago in Eugene. That dart gets him down to the 27-yard line. Mikhailty Williams with the stop.
A start like this. The first down, second first down, hit a big pass. Now you've run for a first down, thrown for one. The offense seems to be in gear.
36 yards on the aerial. Lee brings out one setback, and it's Wilbon. We haven't called Stanley Morgan's number quite yet. He's the big play receiver, flanked to the top. Wilbon again. Good penetration this time. Michael Allen, number 20, coming up from safety. He's a big-time hitter, making the stop for NIU.
You're right, Tim. He played, Michael did, with tremendous leverage on the backside. Allen, in that safety spot last week, is Eastern Illinois, 4 tackles and 2 solo attempts. This guy is outstanding. He's going to need to be to shore that backside up to prevent that cutback lane from coming up, Coach.
No question.
Michael is a redshirt senior. Second and 11.
Looks like they're coming.
Little curl pattern, and it's caught. Look at that by Lindsey. Ties John Lindsey near the first down.
Nice catch, nice run. This is a confident ball skill player. He takes the ball with both hands and then gets into a run after catch as fast as he can. Really a nice play.
What's impressive about Lindsey, he's only about 160 pounds soaking wet, but again, because of that size and athleticism, he's able to spin out of that. So sure tackling going to be coming at a premium for the Huskies.
First and 10.
3-for-3 for your quarterback.
Bounce out by Will Bond, shakes one would-be tackler, gets it down to the 10-yard line.
And coach, what about the yards after contact on that play? Initial at the line of scrimmage.
The whole run was all about yards after contact. And, you know, he bounces outside, beats one tackler, and then really runs into the posse, but he gets big-time yards. That's a broken tackle, no doubt.
Yep, that's the second missed tackle in this series opening up. So NIU's got to settle down, get those nerves settled before this near 90,000 crowd in Lincoln.
That's Mikel Allen, too, one of their better tacklers that he shred. Second down and 3. Uh-oh. They were sitting on it, and it's picked off. Northern Illinois comes away. It's Shawan Lurie, the All-America candidate for the Huskies.
Well, obviously, they have a very efficient drive. They take themselves down to the 10-yard line, and they're in a position now where they're behind 7.
Remember just yesterday, guys, I asked Tanner Lee. I said, you guys mentioned all the people you want to stay from. They didn't mention number 19. Lurie did a tremendous job of squatting on that and settling in. That's his 5th interception this year. Outstanding job by this young, talented player at the cornerback.
And they very rarely throw it, Lurie. In fact, talking with Kevin Kane, the defensive coordinator of Northern Illinois, he said, I don't know how many times you'll get to say his name because no one throws in that direction. Well, they did today, and you found out why the scouting report is what it is.
Well, he's a preseason Jim Thorpe Award candidate. You just saw why.
A stunned crowd of nearly 90,000 as Lee sees one go the other way across the crowd.
This isn't a rivalry. It's worse. It just sits there until finally you get the chance to make it right or continue the nightmare forever.
For those who know what they're really building, always unstoppable.
When food is good and clean and real, it's okay to crave. And with Panera Catering, there's more to go around. Panera, food as it should be.
Love it, shop it, own it. eBay fashion.
You misplaced your debit card. You have Wells Fargo, right?
Yeah.
Open up the app.
Okay.
And turn off your card.
Grandma, how are you better at this than me?
You know, you can use that phone to call me.
What's up, Jamie? What's that?
It's the new Ring Spotlight Cam. Lets you see and talk to anyone on your property right from your phone.
Anyone?
Anyone.
Solicitors?
Yeah.
Car thieves?
Sure.
At night?
It's got a light.
What about bears?
Yep.
Pirates?
Probably.
Ninjas?
Depends.
Giant squids?
Definitely.
Regular squids?
Has to.
Aliens?
For you, of course.
I'll take 6.
See and speak to visitors right from your phone. Check it out at ring.com.
FS1 College Football is presented by Dave and Buster's. After a really nice drive, a big Interception return for a touchdown by Sean Lurie, 87 yards to give the Huskies an early 7-0 lead. So Christian Hagan will tee it up again. And Tyjon Lindsey and J.D. Spielman are once again in deep safety. Difficult blow for Tanner Lee, who's been beset with pass interceptions. Some his fault, some not his fault. And here comes Tyjon Lindsey again. He's out to the 17-yard line. Spence, Les, let's take a look at how he squatted on this and moved.
Coach wants to take a look at the discipline of his eyes. Big back inside in for the quarterback. His eyes are focused. That's film study. He sees the little off-the-ball motion there. No false step. He drives on that, takes it to the house.
Yeah, it's more than film study. That play was practice. They're keying the inside receiver. If the inside receiver slows, he's getting the ball. If the inside receiver goes to block, the outside guy's getting the ball. But their key is the inside receiver. That's why Lurie makes the play.
He just read the body language. It was just a brilliant job of focusing, securing the catch, and hitting his head on the goalpost the opposite direction.
Really, one of the problems coming in, I think Mike Riley was looking for a fast start, fellas, here at home after the loss in Eugene. You see Wilbon ahead for maybe two, possibly three. And so now for Tanner Lee, it's a bounce back situation. And unless you understand this, you knew this kid, almost got him yourself while at LSU. He became eligible, got a second year because of a rare circumstance within the NCAA and its compliance office. And he's had a lot of losing in his past, and he's got to shake that.
No, it's a brand new day. It's an opportunity, and really he's got to drop what he just did and take his team to the field and perform, be the player he wanted it to be.
A little case of amnesia would help, is what you're saying. Yeah,
that's correct.
There's Personnel. He's a couple of yards shy of the first down. Jalen Embry, number 3, redshirt junior from Detroit's ML King High School, with the stop.
So, Coach, now, and Timmy, it's about the inner game from a quarterback standpoint. 4 interceptions thrown last week. So, Coach, now he's got to get inside his head and then demonstrate that. That's where the confidence comes from, demonstrated ability, not just for himself, but for his teammates and his coaches as well in his play call.
He comes back right away and hits a hitch.
Yep.
But the difference was is there was 2 wides, and there wasn't the key on the inside receiver. There was separation there.
Helping him with the play calling.
Correct.
3rd down and 2. Wilbon trying to bounce outside. Great penetration there again by Northern Illinois. They may not be big, but they are quick. Bobby Jones, the outside linebacker, he goes 220 out of Miami Gardens, Florida. Running and chasing, Spencer.
Yeah, but that was William Lee, number 90, the inside. He's the one that got penetration, that defensive tackle. He got in there and played on the opposite side of the football, and there's nothing that disrupt a play than the defender being on the other side of the line of scrimmage.
Caleb Lightborn will punt it away, and Jalen Embry, number 3, is back deep. Standing around his 31-yard line. 4th down and a long 1. They do boot it away, a high spiral and a fair catch called for at the 26-yard line. 48-yard boot, no return. We've had some clouds and some sunshine, but right now it's a cloudy moment because of Northern Illinois here in Nebraska.
Football is back at Dave & Buster's with all-you-can-eat wings plus a $10 game card for just $19.99 every Sunday, Monday, and Thursday. Yeah, you heard me right. All-you-can-eat wings plus a $10 game card for just $19.99. Watch the games and play the games only at Dave & Buster's.
This is Jeff applying for a job.
Thank you.
And getting it.
Oh.
This is Jeff's new boss, Susan, closing a big deal and expensing lunch. This is Sean, a waiter, a husband, and now, a father. This is Helen, clocking out at the end of a really rewarding day. And this is Jeff again, making his wife's day even better. This is Paycom, doing more for your workforce.
Fubo Chavez here. You know, Fubo TV has dozens of sports channels.
What are you doing?
Telling everybody about the world's biggest sports package.
Holy sh.
Stream the most live sports for the least money. Try Fubo TV free today.
Hello, Discover Card.
Hi, can you tell me about these new Social Security alerts I keep hearing about?
Sure, just sign up online. Then we'll alert you if we find your Social Security number on any one of thousands of risky websites.
Wow, that's cool.
How much is it? Oh, it's free if you have a Discover Card.
I like free.
Yeah, we just want you to be in the know.
Oh, hey, sushi. Oh, I smell it.
You're making me...
Yeah, being in the know is a good thing.
Know if your social security number is found on risky sites. Free from Discover.
Calling all chocolate cake lovers.
If you'll indulge me, I'd love to tell you about our indulgent best chocolate cake blizzard.
It's chocolatey.
Velvety.
Yes, it is rich.
Much like my phone voice.
The new DQ best chocolate cake blizzard and molten lava cake a la mode.
Welcome to Dairy Queen.
Huh. Can't find my debit card.
Oh, no.
Oh, it's fine.
Yeah, totally, it's fine. But, like, is it fine, though? Because I would maybe be worried. Really, really, really worried. Do you want me to go back and look for it? I will. I mean, a lot of bad things can happen. You need to call the bank. I don't know how else to tell you. You need to shut that card off. What?
I can turn it on and off in my Wells Fargo app.
I feel better already.
Good.
These are Domino's all-new Parmesan-dusted, garlic-seasoned, and cinnamon-sprinkled bread twists. How did we come up with such a clever name? We'll never tell. Choose any two of Domino's new bread twists or medium two-topping pizzas for $5.99 each.
Dynamic performance, trap-tuned handling, and aggressive styling. The bold Lexus IS.
Lease the 2017 IS Turbo for $299 a month for 36 months.
Experience amazing at your Lexus dealer.
Andrew Miller, he's back, the reliever, back since Thursday from that knee injury, trying to get the Indians back on track after that 22-game winning streak came to an end last night against the Kansas City Royals. That game coming up in about 44 minutes right here on FS1.
Big nasty.
Welcome to the MLB on FS1 pregame show, sponsored by the Lincoln Motor Company. Oh, man, it's Mike Hill. It's Big Poppy talking about Big Nasty. It's A-Rod, and we just saw a big upset. We saw Northern Illinois knocking off Nebraska. You guys, big college football.
Great way to spend a Saturday here in our Fox studios watching a little football, a lot of baseball.
That's awesome, man.
Here with Big Poppy.
That's awesome.
That's great. I'm on the set with these two guys right now. You say you got a Big Poppy, you got a story about Big Nasty?
Of course. I mean, you know he used to be with Boston, and then every time we play Baltimore, Chris David, the first baseman for the Baltimore Orioles, he was like, he making look bad with the slider and everything. So one time I got to first base after he strike out, and I was like, how does it feel facing Miller? And he was like, oh, miserable. He was like, oh, man, this guy, he made my life miserable. A week later, he got traded to Baltimore. I got to face him. And he asked me the same question. Papi, how he feel face Miller now?
Did he make your life miserable?
Oh, my God. He threw that slider on me. I don't know where it came from. He struck me out. And then I was thinking about, man, this is a payback kind of type of thing. You know what I'm saying? Now yeah. I got to face him a week later. We were talking about it a week before, you know. But this guy, man, he's filthy. He got the best slider 98. When he feels good, he go up to 100. Good luck, guy. I don't have to deal with that anymore.
You know, Mike, I had a great privilege to play with Andrew Miller. Not only a world-class pitcher with a fastball and slider off the charts, but also dynamic in the clubhouse, extremely intelligent, spoke up in meetings, studied video on the plane. Just a guy. And I said this in the World Series last year, and I meant it. If you have a daughter, you want him to marry a guy like Andrew Miller.
Oh, wow. Definitely. Big compliment right there.
I'm telling you, he's the kind of guy that at the beginning of his career, he was having issues with his command. All of a sudden, now he know how to pitch. He know where to locate his pitch. He know where to go. And he know exactly what to throw you at certain situation that he's facing. But it's felty, man. He got the best stuff in the game, I guess.
Hey, Rod, you should have told him how to hit Andrew Miller. You were 3-for-5 in your career against Andrew Miller. Poppy, you were 1-for-8.
Numbers can be deceiving, Mike.
But you know what? But you help out Poppy in a lot of different ways, especially early today. You guys are Natalie Klatt. You look really good. And the reason why Big Poppy has such a great tie on right now is because of this guy. Check this out earlier today.
I never thought I would be doing Big Poppy's tie after so many heartbreaking home runs and defeats, but ooh. Yeah, baby.
Get it ready.
Big Poppy looking clean.
I'm trying to be like A-Rod, guys.
Don't do that.
Looking good, man.
He tried to choke me on that one right there, man. I was feeling a little tight right here.
He tried to choke you? You tried to choke him? Come on, what? Was this, you still got that Yankees Red Sox robbery going on?
I was trying to choke him in 04 when he was, you know, making our life miserable.
A-Rod, we shouldn't talk about chokes.
I know. Listen, you got to own it, baby.
This one was something. Cleveland. Great story in baseball. Of course, that 22-game winning streak came to an end. Check it out.
The Cleveland Indians have set a new American League record, winning their 21st consecutive ball game.
Believe, Lance, I believe in the land. I believe in what we have. I believe in what we accomplish as a group, as a whole city.
And history marches on.
It's awesome. I've never experienced that before. So to be able to enjoy these moments like we're in right now is pretty special for all of us.
We have a team who embraces challenges, doesn't back down from adversity, and we're going to go out there and try to find a way to win the ballgame.
The Indians continue this improbable run.
I think the city of Cleveland is a lot like our team. They've been pushed around, and now it's time to start pushing back.
What an amazing run it was. I mean, look at this, what they were able to accomplish during that 22-game win streak. Look at that run differential, man. Plus 105, 41 home runs, starting pitching ERA, incredible. And the most amazing stat to me is the innings they trailed. 8 total innings in 22 games. That's amazing. So when you look back on this streak, put it in perspective for me.
Yeah, it's hard because even when Oakland a few years back had the streak, it seemed like they were walking off every day. Cleveland, basically, the average score was 7-2. It was world domination. You know, but for me, a team that has potentially co-MVPs with Jose Ramirez and Francisco Lindor, the most valuable person for me is Tito Francona. Yeah, yeah. In a world where being the conduit between these sabermetrics front offices to these clubhouses that are full of millennials, to fill that gap, no one does it better than Tito Francona.
I totally agree. Playing for Tito Francona is like playing for your dad. He make you feel comfortable. He build your confidence somehow, some way at the highest level. All of a sudden, you performing in the middle of a team where in the late 90s, they dominate that division. Mm-hmm. Then it go into the middle of the 2000s, and you don't know what was going to happen. It was a little shaky. All of a sudden, Tito walk in as a manager. Now you are in the World Series, and look how the season is going for them. So I think Tito Francona got to be the best manager in baseball right now.
You know, Poppy, he broke a streak of 86 years and won 2 championships with the Red Sox, one at my expense, actually, two. And if he breaks this streak of 69 years with the Cleveland Indians, for me, he has cemented his spot in Cooperstown.
He definitely, you know, make you – he there's a gap in between – the front office, the silver matrix, everything that is going on right now. But managing a team is like the human body. If you have a good head, the body knows what it goes for. Mm-hmm. If you don't have a good head, you know the body's going to be all over the place. That's what Tito Francona brings to the table for the Cleveland Indians.
He just mentioned him as the best manager in baseball, but Poppy could be a little bit biased. Do you agree with him? Do you think he's the best manager in baseball?
86 years with the Red Sox and potentially now 69, he is cementing himself not only as a Hall of Famer, but one of the game's best personalities, great communicators. You can't argue with that.
All right, we came on a little bit early. You're watching FS1, Mike Hill, A-Rod, and Big Poppy David Ortiz. We're getting you ready for the Kansas City Royals, who ended that 22-game winning streak against Terry Francona and the Cleveland Indians in just a second. But let's get you caught up on other action.
Let's see some highlights, Mike.
You want to see some highlights?
Yeah.
Bring it. One of your favorite former teams, the Mariners, taking on the Astros, and George Springer right here. Back up the middle. Two runs will score, and the Astros take the 3-0 lead, all in support of Dallas Keuchel, who's on the hill today. And then in the fifth,
veterano.
Carlos Beltran.
Yes, warming up for October. Carlos Beltran.
Yes, Jose Altuve scores. Astros with the lead there. Dodgers and Nationals, this game also on Fox, and Cody Bellinger.
A bomb, I said, rookie. You know how hard that is?
Well, yeah, he's hit done it 38 times. That's the NL rookie record. Dodgers take a 1-0 lead. Then Bellinger, you can also hit singles there. That scores Chase Utley. Justin Turner safe. Dodgers up 2-0. All right, so the Dodgers going for their 4th straight win. But before that, of course, they had lost 11 in a row, 15-16. Before the season, when the season began, they got out to that great start. A lot of pressure on the Dodgers, of course, to win the World Series. Can they get it done in the postseason? With that recent slump, though, did it take a little bit of the pressure off of them?
I think so, Mike. I think it has alleviated them. It's humanized them. And now they get a chance to reset. But when you think about, for me, it's going to come down to Clayton Kershaw like it does every year. Okay. If Big Poppy and I are on the same team, we're not going to be able to sneak into a world championship Big Papi has to go off, I have to go off. The same is true for Clayton Kershaw.
Totally agree. I think Kershaw is going to have to bring something very special to the table. He's going to have to separate himself like he normally do in the regular season during the playoff. Plus, the offense, once that offense take off, I think it's going to be a wrap.
And that's a good point. Their big issue has been offense. Yeah. They're number one in ERA in the bullpen. They're number one in strikeouts. They got Bellinger and Seager back. They're a completely different team. That three-run average should bump up to 4 or 5 runs.
You got to be healthy. You mentioned that three-run average. That's been over the last 20 games when they've really struggled. But going back to a Clayton Kershaw, we know what he's been able to do in the regular season. It's been amazing, maybe the best pitcher in baseball. But it's been the postseason issues that has been a problem for him. Obviously, you guys have been in the postseason. You, one of those superstar players, along with Barry Bonds and Clayton Kershaw, some postseasons didn't work out for you, but it happened for you, and it worked out, and you turned things around in 2009. Yeah. How does a guy like Clayton Kershaw, superstar who's been struggling in the postseason, turn it around for him?
Yeah, I mean, the volatility they've been dealing with over the last, call it, 6 weeks is going to be a moot point. At the end of the day, it starts and it ends with Clayton Kershaw. And if the Dodgers are able to get the world-class guy that's been for his entire career during the regular season, they will be able to bring the championship back to the
Dodgers. Do you take some of the pressure? Do you just, like, what did you do? What was different that year? Did you take some of the pressure off yourself and just say, you know what? Even though it's the postseason and you're playing in New York, where the stakes are always high, even in the regular season, especially in the postseason, did you take some of the pressure off yourself and say, you know, I'm just going to have this different type of approach?
Yeah, great question, Mike. I think for me, especially 04, 05, there was so much energy put on, you know, Schilling going over there, me going to the Yankees, that I thought it was tennis. I was trying to do 1 against 9.
Listen, wow. Man, I was only in favor when this guy come to the plate.
It was too much pressure. But you know what? In 09, I said, screw it. You know what? I'm going to go out every day, and if I can do one thing, just one thing, Poppy, to help my team win, it simplified it, it relaxed me, and obviously it worked.
That's a good point, definitely. Sometimes, you know, the pressure comes from different direction, and you got to, you know, pick your spot where you want to go. And at the end of the day, the result is going to be what you bring to the table for your ball club to win a ball game.
Why were you so good in October? I've never seen anything like that. It pains me to ask you this question, but I'm going to ask it anyways.
I wasn't paying attention to things around me. I would just basically, like, I was putting some earplug, and I was just, like, focusing on the guy that was in the mound. And like we talked about before, you know, a guy like us, we know that we're not going to get no cheat shop out there. We're gonna have to bring something special to the table for the ball club that we are playing for, walk home with a W. So it's not a free pass on this.
No. Thanks for the nightmares and earplugs. That's all we needed. All right, go ahead, Mike. Jeez.
17 career postseason home runs for Poppy, but A-Rod, as a Yankees fan, want to thank you.
What's going on here?
Coming up, it's been a tale of two halves for Aaron Judge. Speaking of the Yankees, we head over to the demo field with A-Rod and Big Pop.
All right.
And show you how they would fix the young Yankees.
Yeah, baby. Bronx.
Rise up again. Plus, find out how the Indians are using last year as motivation to get back to the World Series.
All the big dreams, all the wins, all the stolen bases, double plays, punch-outs, and walk-offs. Doesn't mean anything now. Because the only thing that matters is October.
With 33 individual vertebrae and 640 muscles in the human body, no two of us are alike. Life made more effortless through adaptability. The perfect position seat in the Lincoln Continental.
CourseheadSwivelyChair.com. It could be the next big thing. I should totally get that domain name.
Get your great idea online, too. Get your domain name today and get a free trial of GoCentral from GoDaddy.
Introducing Hut Rewards from Pizza Hut. Finally, a rewards program that gives you points toward free pizza with every dollar you spend online. And get unlimited double rewards through October 1st. Don't settle for a piece of the pie. Join Hut Rewards today and earn free pizza faster. That's why no one out-pizzas the Hut.
What up, Dome?
Good to see you, man.
You ready to do this?
First things first, I'm Nick Wright. That's the Hall of Famer Chris Carter. What up, CC?
I've seen them all. Big, small, wide, slim, but never too